Thank you. visible. How do we know who God is? He says, and why do you want to spread God? Isn't he like right routine? Because we got to show something to the Father. I'm going to go to the next one.
spend all the time that you don't have to bring this down. You even put your life in that. And you even invest your life in the things that you don't understand. You know, they were in the school system, a bunch of people take that two-ton aircraft and do a fly up with a bird, and that's pretty good. You know, but there are things that have built into this world that have even beyond our lack of understanding the science that we have to do, and so we don't have to do it with brains and using yourself out of the good news that he wants to live in. He wants us to live in this place that we have to set up and to be able to set up it. I'm going to go to the next one. through the gospel of this message, but through our life. No doubt it's true. And then God has said, I want to know. You guys pray for that, you know? And when my body's sick, I pray for it. I'm elevating his word about my experience and becoming a hearer, Lord, and my experience is this. That's living in the gospel. And I thank you that I'm here. I thank you that I have to understand and realize that you have given me everything I need. And that even in the midst of this godly storm, I'm at peace and will be truly with you. I believe in you. This is the way I think of the Bible. That you need this body in order to be a function of your body to do this work. So I know, Lord, that my body can be healed and mended, and I'm not continuing to do this body to do it. After all, you're not trying to do through this sickness and stuff. It's not the truth. You don't do things like that. But you know, I still have that in my life. Good news thing that I believe, and I continue in the gospel that way. And I thank God that there is hope. Clean flood season, it hasn't come on me. Thank you, Jesus. I'm going to continue living in the gospel. You can say, well, hey, you did come on me. What does that mean? Don't be condemned in the spirit. Just kick it out of your life and just believe the gospel and move on. If it comes on me, that's what I'm going to do. Thank you, Jesus, that this is not how you want to be in my body. So I command it to be in Jesus. It doesn't go away. But I wake up the next morning and I still believe the gospel. I still have no right to be in my body. Get out of your name, Jesus. Right, it's still there. I get up in that morning and I say, in the name of Jesus, this will not hit me, this will not hinder me. I thank you, Lord, that by His strength I was here, and that's what I'm going to do. And then right the next day, I'm going to get up again and elevate His word above my experience, and I'm going to live in the gospel. And what did you guys say? Well, then I'm going to die believing the gospel. And when I wake up in eternity, He's going to say, well done, good and faithful servant, you glorified me above your experience. That's what living in the gospel is. That's what living in the gospel is. Keeping it going. Thank you. history of the number is not the devil that comes to you to want to do something that God has already made you, but you just don't know about it? Just say, thank you. I'm like, what if you?
Thank you.
money, right? Because you know that Christ is here to preach the law in order to get them to say, God, well, you don't even be saved. This is impossible. He's like, I know. This is what I'm here. I'm the Savior. And I will give it to you by grace through faith. You cannot return righteousness to Christ. So why would you just say,
you
I'm going to go to the next one.